Welcome to the first video by INSPIRANTE. We are a group of students based in Pune. Our primary goal is to inspire our fellow students. We intend to help students identify their interests and achieve excellence in the same. As a part of this venture, we are interviewing Surendra Bhave, who is a former first-class cricketer and national selector. So let's go. Hello and welcome to the first episode of INSPIRANTE Talks. Today we have with us Mr. Surendra Bhave. Cricket is known as a game of gentlemen, and that becomes apparent after meet Bhave sir. From 1986 to 2001, he was a first-class cricketer and has captained the state of Maharashtra on numerous occasions. After retirement, he shifted his focus towards coaching. He has also toured the remote parts of Maharashtra to spot young talent. From 2008 to 2011, he was in the national selection panel. Currently, he is working as the coach of the Ranji cricket team of Maharashtra. So, hello, sir.
Hello.
It's a pleasure to have you here.
Hello.
So, I think let's begin with the first question.
Yeah.
So, how did you fall in love with cricket?
Like any other kid, I followed my brother, who was already a cricketer. He has also played first-class cricket, played in Ranji Trophy. And Subhash Nagar, where I lived, had a distinct sports culture, and especially cricket. A bit parallel to what you had in Hindu Colony in Mumbai, we also had lots of cricketers coming from that area in Pune. So basically it was where I lived. And also the fact that I got selected to play inter-school cricket very early, I got soaked into the atmosphere and I started enjoying playing cricket.
When did it dawn on you that you wanted to pursue cricket as a profession, and what kept you going?
None of us actually planned our careers like that. In that era, most people played for enjoyment. They played cricket because they loved the game, and eventually the career followed. And it was initially the passion for the game which was so important. And it's important that a cricketer has those virtues as patience and longevity, because the game itself is played for 6 or 7 hours a day. So it's important that you have those virtues. Once you have those virtues, continuing till you're fit enough to play the game is not so hard.
So can you narrate an incident that changed your life or had a deep impact on you?
What changed my perception was one or two serious injuries which I had pretty early in my career. I think it was some 84, 85 when I got hit with a bouncer on the head. And most people now don't know that batters played without helmets in those days. So it was a risk-filled thing, and quicks were very good because people were tested firstly on their courage, and I got injured on my head and actually was laid down by the injury for a long period. And being laid down like that made me realize how I wanted to do well in this game. And the nature of the injury was pretty serious, so it took me almost 4 months to get back onto the ground. And a couple of months of that time was actually spent in the hospital. That actually made me realize how badly I wanted to play this game and play this game successfully. So in a very strange way, I think injuries changed my perception about how to go about in this game.
So as a player, you must have had a mentor, and you are now mentoring successful cricketers like Kedar Ambatkar. So what role does a mentor play in the life of a cricketer?
Mentors do play a very important role. Mentor is a modern concept. What we know in Marathi and Hindi, the coaches are called Margadarshak in Marathi and Hindi, and that's what it is actually. Somebody who can show you the path and also encourage you in your down period when you're not doing so well in the game. Somebody who can encourage you. Somebody who can actually tell you how to prepare for this game physically and mentally. And somebody who is actually, if you're on the cricket field and you know going through a skill, somebody who can quietly observe and let you know what else can be done better, you know, how you can refine your game. and basically be an encouraging factor. That's what being mentor is. If you actually only consider the concept of being a mentor, it's more to do with mental strength and mental skills than the physical skills, than the actual skills of the game. So in both ways, I think Margadarshak, that concept included all this.
Okay.
This is kind of a person who is behind the curtain and not necessarily doing interviews like I'm doing today, but is instrumental in putting the players in the right frame of mind. And if you're in a good headspace in professional sport, more or less you're going to do very well.
So, as you know, cricket is a religion in our country, and every other kid dreams of becoming a cricketer. But unfortunately, only 11 players get an opportunity to play in a national team. So you have been a national selector. So what do you think are the prerequisites for reaching that level?
Prerequisites of reaching that level, obviously the first one I would pick out is hard work. You need to be a committed person to get there. And as you have pointed out, that it's a number game. And you are actually competing against thousands and thousands of good cricketers. That's what it is. To separate yourself, you need to have mental skill as well as the physical skills to get onto the field and perform at the international level. Another virtue which a cricketer needs is to actually put his best effort in the preparation part. A lot of us feel that if you do well in the matches, you are very good temperamentally. You are very good temperamentally if you are putting your best effort in the preparation phase. Only if your preparation is top class, you're going to stand some chance to do well at international level. And also, we have heard this before. People say that the journey is more important than the destination. So this is where it counts. In a professional sport, your preparation, your hard work, your commitment means a lot. And if you do that on a day-to-day basis with a smile on your face, and if the hard work is not too much for you, you have a better chance of succeeding in any professional sport.
So, an interesting question. What is more important, hard work or talent? I mean, can a player with limited talent reach a respectable level only through his hard work?
Somebody with limited talent can reach a respectable level. Somebody with extreme talent can reach the highest level. But the common denominator is hard work. And I have a entirely different definition of the word talent itself. I think talent for me is if you're blessed with certain skills which are above normal, then you need the smartness to utilize those skills to be a better player. And the person who has got the smartness to utilize his talent, his natural talent, is the guy who is talented. Because too many times one has seen in professional sport that people are extremely talented when you look at them, but don't achieve that much. They don't achieve as much as their potential is because the hard work part and using your smartness to utilize your natural ability is separating them. So I think, yes, it's important to be blessed with natural ability. It's important that you have the right work ethics, but it's most important that you have the smartness to use what has been blessed upon you.
That was very insightful indeed. So, how should an aspiring sports person review his or her performance to ensure that they are on the right track?
Firstly, I think it's important to have realistic goals. I can sit here and say that I want to be in an X position in next 2 years or whatever. But there's some long-term planning, there's some short-term planning, and you need to sort of have patience to deliver those plans. But I think being realistic is very, very important. So your self-assessment is very important. It has to be brutally honest and it has to be realistic. It's important to have both. I think most successful sportsmen in their careers have been very hard on themselves when they don't achieve targets. And that's a virtue which everybody doesn't have. Most people go out to bat and they're happy with a 40. People who want to get ahead and play for India are not happy before they get 100. Or a bowler would be happy with a 2-wicket haul for 30 runs, his day is done, so he can have a nice evening. Somebody who wants to professional cricket and play for India would say, I needed a fifer, I needed 5 wickets today to boost my confidence and not for too many runs, and that was my proposed target. So it's about chasing your targets, it's about setting realistic targets, and it's about being brutally honest with yourself and your self-assessment. And if you are able to do that, aspiring cricketers and aspiring sportsmen can actually achieve better results.
So what are your views on the risk that is involved in pursuing cricket as a profession?
It was very risky when I played my cricket. It was extremely risky for the generations before me. Now the risk factor is being taken care of a little bit, because I said earlier in this interview that cricket is a viable career option. If you have small targets like playing for your state at junior level, then playing for your state at Ranji level, those are realistic targets and you can achieve those. Luckily for us, BCCI and the governing bodies have made sure that if a cricketer gets to a first class level, he is remunerated to such an extent that he can actually have a 5-year plan and be successful both on financial front and on his cricketing front. So it's a nice balance now. Professionals are compensated much better than before, and hence it is realistic to aim for a cricket career or for a career which probably starts at first class level, and probably the pinnacle of it would be to represent India. If you have realistic targets, it's achievable. I know the competition these days is very, very tough, extremely tough competition. But if the competition is tough, it actually gets the best out of you and you put in more effort. So one who doesn't shy away from tough competition can do well in this game and do well in professional sport in general.
So this question, the next one, is from the perspective of students, especially who are in their education fields. So even today they face criticism for opting for sports over studies. So how should a student deal with such criticism?
I think firstly, you need to assess where your career lies. You need to know. And I don't think it's impossible to have a safe graduation period, both in cricket and in studies. I think if one's pursuing to be a cricketer, he can easily, you know, put a little bit of effort and at least try to be a graduate, you know, and that's entirely possible. You know, I've known cricketers, we know cricketers who have been engineers and played for India. You know, we talk about Rahul Dravid and Jabagal Srinath and Kumble all being engineers and playing for India. I don't think both things are sort of impossible to achieve. But then again, you need to know your limitations. If you think your assessment tells you that you can't get too ahead in your sports career, then you might as well concentrate on your studies. And it's important to strike a very nice balance between the two. But it's entirely possible from the examples we know that both can be achieved. And more and more people are now giving importance to a sports career. And it also stems from how your parents feel about your career. Okay? And if the parents are not overwhelming about having a very good academic career and sort of liberal to the idea of making a sports career, then this can be achieved easily.
So that brings us to the final question. What advice would you give to aspiring cricketers?
Commitment is very, very important. Very famously, many, many years ago, Martina Navratilova said that there's a difference between involvement and commitment. And she says, with an egg, the hen is involved, and with a bacon, the pork is committed. That's what she said. I think it's a great quote. And you need a lot of commitment. If you want to make a sports career, you need a lot of commitment. If you want to have a very bright academic career, you need commitment. That's very important. One thing which the modern sports field is drifting away from a little bit, and I can tell you from my personal experiences, that parents at home and teams have to tell each other to bring in the most important principle of sport is to actually have gratitude. Okay. It's very important. It's very hard to come by these days. And a lot of sportsmen are forgetting at this point in time that even though they're chasing the targets of their careers very sincerely and putting in a great effort, something which you cannot forget and we teach kids at home is the principle of gratitude. And I think if you have commitment and if you have gratitude, you can make a good cricket career or a sports career.
Thank you. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.